know something. This is the only thing I have. I'm giving it to the Lord. She never said that at all. Now Moses was the pastor. Moses was the pastor of the congregation. He heard from the Lord. He came down and he said that this is not me. It is the Lord who commanded. It's written here, whoever is of a willing heart, let him bring it as an offering to the Lord. That's why I'm telling you, offering is not a commitment. It's a free will. It's up to you want to give or not. Hallelujah. See, why do you want to take offering? To build the tabernacle of God. We are in the church today. We are in the church today. And if it is called as tabernacle, then it is church as well. See, that's why when we come to church, this is why we take offering. Hallelujah. See, although tithes and offering given for the same purpose, both are different. Tithes is your commitment. Offering is your free will. Hallelujah. But the purpose is the same. It's for the ministry. Today, we do give God our usual offerings. For example, the service will take offering, do the online transaction, Thanksgiving offering, the vow offering. Vow means like when you made an vow to the Lord saying that, okay, Lord, if you help me on this, if you do this for me, I will give this much to you. I will give this much of a month to you. Or maybe I will cook for the church members, or I will provide for some people. This is vow offering. We call this a vow offering. And then Thanksgiving offering, remembering all the goodness of God throughout the years, and then giving some kind of offering. See, there's many kind of offering in the Old Testament, and even the New Testament, the people have practiced that. Hallelujah. So offering is basically, it's a free will. It's not a commitment or anything, but God sees your heart. That's why God clearly mentioned that those who are willing heart, they have to give. If their heart is stirred up to give, then they have to give. Hallelujah. So as a Christian, when we appear before God, we need to bring something to the Lord. It's an act of worship. In the book of Exodus 23 verse 15, it's written that none shall appear before me empty handed. Hallelujah. Everyone who appears before God must bring something. He is the king. You know, those days, the kings, when you go before the king, you must bring something, a presentation, a fruit, a food, anything. He will enjoy it, and then he'll ask you, okay, what's your case? Tell me. So the practices come forward in this generation as well. When we come before God, we give an offering for the Lord. Hallelujah. And our offering is also a part of worship. When you give offering, some people, until now they're giving offering, they don't really know why they're giving offering. Offering is a part of worship. Why? Because when I was small, my grandmother used to give me a 1 ringgit, 2 ringgit, and say that, okay, go put offering in Sunday school. So we grow up, we don't know, we truly don't understand why we have to give offering to the church. What is the purpose? We know, of course, it is for church maintenance, but what is it to do with us? Why we should give? You know? And then when I grow in the spiritual, then I understand it is a part of worship. When you give, it's a way of you expressing your love. God loves the world so much that He gave His one and only Son. Giving is a way of expressing your love. So you love God. When you give, you are expressing your love. Hallelujah. So it's a part of worship. See, part of worship. Just like how singing song is a part of worship, giving an offering to the Lord is a part of worship. Hallelujah. You see, David, a great worshipper. You know, David is a great worshipper. There was never once someone who can worship God like him. Never once after him. Hallelujah. No one before him, no one after him. A man after God's own heart. A worship, true worshipper of God. Today when it comes to worshipping, what would say that? Singing songs. But look at this worshipper. He says that, I'm offering a burnt offering to the Lord. Since he is the king, he was looking for an animal to sacrifice to God. So he asked the owner of the animal, can you give me that? I will buy it from you. He said, king, all the land is yours. Take whatever you want. You know? But David, he did not use his power and fame. Said, okay, since you know I'm the king, I'll take everything. No. He did not steal and give. He did what? He purchased it. He said, I will not offer burnt offering to the Lord, which costs me nothing. It must cost me something. I must pay for it. That is true worship. This is something which we should learn from a worshipper like David. So we think that worship is all about things. No, offering is also worship. So this is what you should understand. Each time, you know, when we bring an offering to the Lord, God blesses. God blesses. Sometimes some people say, oh, I myself is insufficient. How can I bring an offering to the Lord? I myself not enough. Every month I'm going to touch into vision. In the book of Mark chapter 12 verse 41 to 43, if you see, there is a widow with a 2 coin who came into the temple treasure and she put in the 2 coin into the temple. From afar, Jesus was watching the widow and noticing her. Many came there, they earned 1,000 ringgit, 2,000 ringgit, they gave everything they have out of their wealth. They gave. But this woman, she gave the only thing that she has to live on. Means there's nothing else other than the 2 coins. She only had the two coins to live, to eat for her livelihood. But what she did, she gave it to the temple of God. She did not tell to people, you all know something, this is the only thing I have, I'm giving it to the Lord. She never said that at all. She did not put a long face. But the one who knows everything noticed that. He knew what she is going through. And he said that it is the only thing that she had to live on. She has given that to God. And we can see Jesus was rejoicing on that. Now, according to today's preachers, what do they expect from Jesus today? They will say that by right Jesus should have gone and stopped and said that you keep this money for yourself. Isn't it? That is how they will teach. You keep that money for yourself. And why did Jesus did not stop her? More than the temple, he is the God. He can make everything in 3 days. He can change everything. By right, he should have gone to stop her saying that, no, you don't give. Keep this. Eat something. Jesus did not say that. Because Jesus knew only when she sow, she can reap from heaven. So he did not stop her from sowing. No, this is what you understand. You are telling that insufficient. Here God knows someone, a lady, a woman is insufficient. He did not stop. Because he knows that she is about to receive a blessing. He knows what she has been going through. And he knows what is going to happen next, the future. So don't keep on saying the insufficient. That's an opportunity to bless God. Many came there, give out of their wealth. None of them, he praised them. But he called the disciples and said, hey, she has put in 2 coins. Many came before, put 1,000 coins inside there. 2,000 coins. No, he didn't bother. It's not the matter of the value. It's not the matter of the amount. She gave out of her poverty. That's the only thing that she had that is so much valuable in the eyes of God. When you give what you had in your hand. So this is the difference. This is the thing that you should understand. When you are giving, when you yourself are not able to give, God sees that very highly. Something great to His sight. Hallelujah. That's your faith. That's a way of you. She loves the temple of God. She knows this is the presence of God. She knows the temple need to be maintained. They need the money for the maintenance. So she said, let me have my part. I also want to make sure this temple has been maintained. She gave that offering. She don't want to miss her turn in giving. When you give, you are expressing your love to God. The Jewish, when they give, they know it's an act of worship. I believe now all of you know why you have to give. Some of you newly learned that giving is a way of worshiping God. Hallelujah. So, this is what we should understand. Hallelujah. Now, how to give? How to give? You must be willing and cheerful to give offering. Most of the time, people, when they want to give offering for the Lord, they come to church and then they put their hands into their handbag or in their pocket. They move around. Hey, which if the note is Mr. Cypri, then you know it's 1 ringgit, 2 ringgit. If it's a bit harsh, you know, it's 15 ringgit, 100 ringgit. No, go aside. I'm looking for the smoother one. Hallelujah. No, this is not the way of giving your offering. You know, the next day there is church. Night itself, you iron. You iron your clothes. You prepare your clothes and everything. In the same manner, you need to prepare your offering at home itself. Even if it is 1 ringgit, Lord, this is the amount that I'm going to give you tomorrow. I prepare this. That is 1 ringgit that you're able to give. Prepare it. Say, Lord, this is a way of me worshipping you. Prepare it in the presence of God. The next day, bring it carefully. Give it to God.